So today, what I've done is my measurement is going to be 3.5 inches away from the edging of the frame. So I have my marker here. So I've marked the back of the bracket to be 3.5 inches. I'll let you know what that is in centimeters in a minute. So that's the where I'm going to put the back. Then here I have my bracket, which is my bracket here, and this section here is the top section. So that's going to be up on the wall. So I've put the back of this on my marking, and that's how far I want the bracket to come away from the wall. What I had to do was to go around and cut these blinds down to size to now fit the window. I just took the tape off this other side here to hold it down, but that's what I had to do. And this blind now is going up on the kitchen window. So I'm now going to drill, mark it out, and get it ready to put it up and clean this window up. Now the holes are drilled and the raw plugs are in, they are ready for me to put the brackets up and then put the blinds up. Right, so now that these are up, what I will do is put it on the line that I marked as my guideline there, and then the screws are dead center. So if you look under, you will see this one's brought forward, but this is still able to be adjusted. So you can straighten it up, you can move it backwards and forward, and if it's not right, I can take the whole thing down and adjust it again. That is the beauty of putting it in the center of the marking than what we've done. So this now is 2.5 centimeters away from the frame of the window. If anything, I will put it back further. So the whole thing now is still three and a half inches. I'd like to explain about this bracket. This section here is the top part of the bracket, and this is the bottom. So this is recess, so this is going up onto the ceiling. When I put the blinds inside, we can either hook it on this little lip that's there and then push the front in, or, which is much more easier, hook it into this one first and then push the back in, lean on it and then push it in. That's what we're going to do next. So I'll give a demonstration while we're down here. So this is the bracket. So here is where this lip fits into this grooves here, and that's what I like about this blind, which makes it easy to put up. You put it in and then it clips, you lean on it and you clip it into place, and it's hooked in at the back here. And also now, when you want to remove it, when you can get to it, can you see the lip there? You put a flathead screwdriver in that little groove there and heave it out. When it's up, it's much more easier to do. And then unhook it. And that's how easy it is to put it up. So what I'm going to do now is put the blind up. So now, oh, beforehand, I always forget this point. This is the pelmet, the facial board that goes up. Sometimes I put this at the top, sometimes I put it at the bottom. It depends. But what I need is on the blind itself, it needs these little things. It needs these little clips that clips on to receive the blinds. And what I do is I line it up. Now it's more easier to slide this into position because these are rigid. These, you have to turn them to take it out and to put it in. These have got little hooks on it which fits in the grooves and you just put them into place. So when it's up on the wall, it is more easier to move these than it is to move this. So let's put this up now. Right, so now that it's in position, we'll put the front ones in first. They're all hooked in and then clip into position. This one's not in. That's it. And now, it is harder for me to centralize it while it's up, but just get a screwdriver and just push it along and centralize it. That's not too bad. And now, we put our facial board on. Right. Squeeze it up as close to the wall as possible as you can, because you can actually put this in down and it will still take it. So it's a matter of just keep on until you get it to the place that you want it, and just clip it, making sure that these are in place actually. There's one there. Right, can you see there's a gap underneath it? You can see there's a gap. Sometimes it's not my fault, but this is just being replastered, so I should do better than that. So what I'll do is I'll take it out and start again and see if I can push it up any further. That's better. That's better. And voila, our blind is up. Hello once again. So now that I've done the blinds, you've seen me preparing it and putting it up and everything. And the last thing you saw is that the blind was forward. So I did take it down and pushed it back so it's flushing with the wall. So here we have our blind. I've got a lot of tidying up around the window to do because the kitchen is still a work in progress. And I'm going to finish it probably next week. But so now the blind's done. So the living room, dining room, the hallway's done, and now we've got to do the tiles, the bathroom, which is mosaic and porcelain tiles. So that's going to be a bit of a task to drill in it. So I'm going to use my diamond drill and do that. So you'll see us doing that. And then we'd be finished. So here we are. So as I said, now I'm selling the blinds, and I'm going to sell them at reasonable prices. And I would love to you to buy my blinds. I have a selection of blinds. This one I'm just showing you the wooden Venetian blinds. So please give us a ring. Everybody likes to have shutters, but I always think that these are the nest
next best things to shutters, because you can get them in all different sizes, and this one is 50 centimeters, and I had the 63 centimeters as well, and it goes down to 38 and different makes. So look it up on the internet. What type of blinds do you want? This is Expression Snow White. So send us an email. I've got details at when this is finished. I've got details on the computer for you to find me. So send me your email and your measurements, and I will give you a quote or an estimate. Give us a ring and we can talk business. Thank you for watching my program. Bye. Thank you.